Give us an idea there of what you started to see as you guys were doing this cover crop research.
Well, I think the first thing you begin to notice is how well the cash crops would respond after a cover crop. And a lot of times when you manage research plots, you're not adding a lot of additional fertilizer, other inputs, because you want to see the treatment effect. And so the cash crops would have this resilience, especially in extreme weather, whether it was dryness or even extreme wetness, which we're seeing this growing season, and they'd perform well. And so, and then the soil too would respond a lot quicker with cover crops. You know, when you're just, would have no-till plots, and it would seem like the soil would still not have the life it would. But if you had a cover crop, you would see a rapid response in terms of aggregation, earthworm activity, just general, you know, there was just more strength to the soil. The color, the moisture level was better with cover crops. Okay. And that's where I think we see the soils responding, is those live root exudates and how everything in the soil, all the microorganisms, macroflora, they respond to that boost. The main things I've measured so far are just trying to track the carbon-nitrogen ratio of our cover crops. We can capitalize on some of that mineralized nitrogen because most of our fields that have cover crops will see a corn crop the next